In today's video, we're going to focus in on the concept of a reversion to the mean, which is something that a lot of folks talk about in trading. Now, the goal of talking about this concept in today's video specifically is to answer one simple question, and that's, are the major index markets, this is the S&P 500, the Dow, the NASDAQ, and the Russell, are all four of those markets too extended, and should we start to do something about that to either take advantage of a reversal, or conversely, start to loosen up on existing positions? Now, to answer this question, there's a few different ways you can go about it. One way is to use data points, and that's the first way I'll discuss here. This is our Stock Volatility Box platform, and inside here, we're going to focus in on this bottom chart, which lets us scan for 15-day analytics to really track and understand when this volatility started to increase. Now, if you take a look at the past 15 days here, really from the 15th of October all the way up till right around the 26th of October, you'll see that volatility was drastically lower compared to where it is right now. For the most part, we had anywhere between 100 to 200 stocks displaying extreme volatility during those specific day periods. However, as soon as the 27th of October hit, you'll see that number drastically increased. Now we are closer to that 400 mark. Volatility took a little bit of a pause, but still substantially above the average leading into that zone. And most recently, November 3rd and November 4th, we've really broken out having volatility in the zones of 500 to 600 trades per day. So that tells you that volatility's really picked up in the marketplace. The last time this happened, if I come to our charts, that's when a move like this happened. So that's something to keep in mind. We don't necessarily expect to see something like this, but at the very least, we expect to see some sort of reversion to the mean, at the very least, back to our market pulse line. Now that naturally leads me into our second segue, which is, let's say you don't have access to the scanner, the analytics, any of that, or even other data points. Well, one very simple way that you can measure if we are extended is by using the Keltner channels and the three standard deviation ranges inside of them. Now, inside of the Keltner channels, you'll notice that there's really two bands, up and down, and then there's a middle line, which is your mean. Specifically, any time price action goes outside of the three standard deviation lines inside of the Keltner channels, that's when we start to expect to see some sort of a pullback back down to that mean. For us, the mean that we're going to be using is the market pulse, and I'll show you what this indicator looks like. It's completely free for you to download. You can click this button to download it. The URL, if I bring this down, is tosindicators.com/indicators/extended-keltner-channels. As soon as you do that, you can click this download button and you can use the same tools that we're going to be talking about in today's video. Now let's start with the S&P 500 first. And I have the Keltner channels loaded in right here. You can see that extended Keltner channels. And that's what's plotting these upside down arrows, both the green ones along with the pink ones, letting us know that we're extended. Now inside of the S&P, we have two specific arrows plotting as of right now. So we know November 3rd, November 4th, yet again, that's when we're starting to see we're officially outside of the three factor Keltner channels. One way that I can also prove this is loading in the actual Keltner channels, change this factor to a 3.0, click apply, and what you'll find is the S&P futures are now outside of that upper band of the three factor Keltner channels. So that's any time the signal will go off. The tutorial linked in that previous link also goes through this in a bit more detail if you're curious. So I'll remove this. So the S&P is telling us that we're extended. Now if we come into the Dow is the one market which out of the four index markets is telling us that we aren't extended, at least as of yet. So we can skip the Dow for this conversation. We move on next to the NASDAQ. The NASDAQ is telling us that it's been extended for quite some time. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 bars. We've also hit the 1272, now making our way up to the 1618 extension, which is at 16537. So the NASDAQ also signaling to us we're a little extended. And finally, if we switch over to the Russell, which is broken outside of that range it's been trading in for quite some time now, if I highlight that first, this entire range, we finally had a breakup above it. That breakout is now also signaling to us two different extended Keltner channel arrows. So out of the four markets we took a look at, the S&P, the NASDAQ, and the Russell, all three of those markets are telling us that, hey, we're a little extended. We start to expect at least a little bit of a reversion back to our mean. Well, how do you know when you'd actually like to take advantage of that signal? For that, it's very simple for me at least, and that's using the Edge Signal Indicator, which is nothing more than an overbought, oversold indicator that we've made for our members. This is free with the Volatility Box membership. The overall setup that I'm looking at is for this extended signal to now actually start to continue panning out, and that first red arrow is where I would start to be looking at a pullback towards the market pulse line. That's where you can use something like out of the money puts to try and take advantage of this move. If I show you what that looks like on the S&P, and let's actually study a past move so you can get an idea of what we're expecting to see. So the few times in the past that this has happened, example one right here, we had our two Keltner channel arrows. We had that pullback. That pullback went all the way back to the market pulse, so no real opportunity there. But this is what we're looking for. We see the arrows starting to plot. We then have that red arrow confirming we're now in overbought territory, and we're looking for a pullback to that market pulse line. Keep coming forward. You'll see that happened again in August. We had 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 arrows. We had then the red arrow that led to a deeper correction inside of the S&P. Keep coming forward here. Yet again, 1, 2, 3, 4, chopped around sideways for a bit until that S&P really didn't continue marching up higher before we still had that reversion to the mean. So very similar concept is what we're looking for here. The opposite also holds true for any time we're extended on the downside. We had these two green arrows. That's then confirmed with our oversold indication right here with the green arrows. And that then confirms that we're looking for the same trend to continue moving in the direction that it was previously. So that's how I would read if we are too extended. I think on three of our major index markets, we are seeing signs that we are too extended. And the signal to actually start to take advantage of this, participate, whatever that may be, for me, is the red arrow from the edge signals indicator. Now, specifically on an intraday time frame, we can start to also take advantage of this volatility using our volatility zones. And in this case, I'm going to use the futures volatility box. Now, using our volatility box zones, there was one market today in which we were able to take advantage of the same volatility that we were seeing, and that was inside of the Russell. The Russell, we started off first on our scalper models. We had a breach towards the end of that 7 to 8 a.m. Pacific hour. We don't take edge of hour trades, but this is free information. This is where we can see what is the market telling us. Do the sellers have full control here where price action continues to go outside of these clouds? Or instead, do the buyers come in, buy up price action, which is letting you know that, hey, any potential fades in the future off of the scalper, we can take advantage of. Well, in the Russell here, price action continued to keep going down. So that free information told you that, hey, the scalper model no longer being respected, it's time to switch on over to something a little bit more conservative with the aggressive volatility box. We load in the aggressive volatility box, and that 8 to 9 a.m. hour was the one place inside of the four major index markets where we had a fade trade opportunity. That's where price action fell inside of our aggressive volatility box ion lines. We were looking for, again, that same edge signal arrow. That green arrow finally came, gave us that confirmation that, hey, volatility starting to calm itself down. This is a good place to try and catch a reversal. We had an entry at that same sign entry line. Our risk is the amount from the sign entry line. Whoops, let me get the trend line tool to the outer edge of the clouds. I'll link a video to the two different setups we have for more detail. I'm going to go through this a little quicker. But the risk here, about 5.6, 5.7 points. We made that 5.6 points almost right away. Stop is then moved to break even for any remaining contracts. And our second target is at the gray target line on the opposite side, which if I zoom out, you'll see was not hit, but instead price action continued to reverse down lower. We hit that break-even stop, and that's where this trade is finally over on any remaining contracts, in this zone right here. So that's where the markets really ended up today. Starting off to recap where we started this conversation, we started with the four major index markets, proving that we're officially extended using the extended Keltner channels, along with the data points that we can see inside of our 15-day scanner analytics. Both of these are telling us, hey, it's time to be a bit more careful. Also telling us, for those of you that are day traders, hey, you can expect some more volatility, and this volatility is how we can capture moves like that one-minute trade inside of Russell off of the aggressive volatility box. All right, I hope this video was helpful. Good luck, everyone. Good luck trading. Hope you have a great close of the week, and we'll see you in the next update.